Hey guys, how's it going? I'm Kelly Pally and this is Top 10 Nerd. So you guys loved our first two parts on the alternate versions of Batman, so here we are with a third edition. So let's just jump right in. In at number 10 is Hollywood Batman. So imagine if Birdman was actually about Batman, and you would have our number 10 spot, Hollywood Batman. Things get meta, and actor Brian Wyatt is convinced he's a real superhero. There's even a great panel where he shouts into an issue of Detective Comics number 27 that he's not a comic book character. Campy but sad, Hollywood Batman would be like if Adam West Batman was around but more tragic. So in this world, Batman is a fictional character, and Brian White plays Bruce Wayne, with Robin being played by a war veteran who has to wear a hairpiece. Fun. When the mob shoots Brian in the head after he won't give them the film profits, he starts believing he's actually Batman. But hey, he does end up beating some criminals, so wasn't for nothing. In at number 9 is Nosferatu Batman. A product of the Elseworlds imprint, Batman Nosferatu was a part of a trilogy based on German expressionist cinema. We talk a bit about this one in our alternate versions of the Joker too, so make sure you check that video out next. Anyway, in this one shot, Dr. Arkham has been holding psychomantic seances for the wealthy of Metropolis, and these star the Laughing Man, aka the Joker, who in this world is a murderous cyborg. Bruce Wayne, our Germanized hero, is suspicious and investigates Arkham when he's captured and turned into the Nosferatu. He then takes down the Laughing Man and the High Chancellor. This alerts Superman, who he battles, and they end up settling on letting Nosferatu control the dark while Superman controls the light. And Bruce becomes the new director of Arkham Asylum. Nosferatu Batman is definitely a whole lot less screamier than Vampire Batman if you haven't gotten your vamp fix yet, so definitely check this one out. And at number 8 is Reverend Batman, or Bat Priest, from Holy Terror. Oh god, no pun intended. But really, here's the Reverend. He lives in a world where the US is a Commonwealth nation run by a corrupt theocratic government. He does none of the things that you love about Batman. He prays a lot, he sings lots of gospel songs, and is apparently really susceptible to breaking out in tears, often. This Batman deals with the death of his parents in a very different way, through God. His suit is actually a costume his father wore in a passion play. Other superheroes make appearances in this world, including Aquaman and the Flash. And there's even several panels about how an evil scientist tried mating Aquaman and a merwoman, creating a strange fish-like creature who lives in a tank. There's also a character called Green Man, who is the equivalent of Superman and basically looks like Jesus nailed to the cross. Also, fun fact, Holy Terror was the first comic to bear the Elseworlds logo. At 7, we've got Bat-Zaro. Meet Wayne Bruce. Yeah. So Bat-Zaro is a villain who is the doppelganger of Batman, so basically the Bat-Bizarro. Not to be mistaken with Bizarro Batman, he first appeared in 1966 World's Finest Comics, but returned post-crisis in Superman Batman number 20 in 2005. Created by the Joker, he's basically a carbon copy of Bizarro in terms of characterization, which was a bit of a disappointment. Unlike his doppelganger, Bat-Zaro shot and killed his own parents, and often has verbal diarrhea, repeating what's just been stated in his thought bubbles. Some speculate that he's actually a part of a separate Earth where other Bizarro inhabitants dwell. What do you guys think? And at 6, we've got Lego Batman. How could we not touch on Lego Batman in this series? Lego Batman has made many appearances in mainstream media, from his own video game to the Lego movie. Will Arnett voices the character and reprised his role in Lego Batman, which hit theaters earlier this year. Can we also really briefly talk about the cast for this film? Ralph Fiennes as Alfred, Zach Galifianakis as the Joker, Michael Cera as Robin, and Rosario Dawson as Batgirl, and Conan O'Brien as the Riddler. Talk about a dream team. Anyway, back to why Lego Batman is awesome. He's hilarious, managing to parody some of the earlier Batman film adaptations, but never getting into really campy territory like our good friend Adam West. And he takes the edge off the brooding character we all love, which isn't always a bad thing. At 5, just imagine Batman. From Stan Lee and Joe Kubert's Just Imagine series, this Batman lives on Earth 6 and is a wrestler. This Batman's alter ego is Wayne Williams, who after being sent to jail for a crime he didn't commit, seeks revenge on the gang leader who set him up, named Hans. In an attempt to be low-key, Wayne shaves his head when he's released and starts a career as a wrestler to make money, calling himself Batman, dressing like a literal bat. He blows up, making a ton of money, and he takes the opportunity to hunt down Hans, who falls to his death when the two come face to face. This prompts Batman to start fighting crime. He's a man in a literal bat suit. At number 4, we've got Pirate Batman from Elseworlds Detective Comics Annual 7. A couple of you mentioned this one in the comments in our previous videos, so we wanted to feature him on this list. Pirate Batman is also known as Captain Leatherwing, who works for the British government raiding ships of England's enemies. He has an earring, he kicks a shark in the face, he kills. And he's a wee bit sexist, but what pirate isn't? And the variations of other characters in this storyline? Well, Alfred is a sass-filled servant named Alfredo, obviously Italian. Catwoman is Capitana Felina. The Joker is another pirate named Laughing Laughing Man. And Robin is Robin Redblade, who is questionable at best, and seems to be a bit of a fanboy of the Captain. Jokes aside, this one's pretty cool and you should definitely check it out. At number 3, we've got Cowboy Batman, or rather, Colonel Bruce Wayne. Oh, the blue, the gray, and the bat. Cute. Here we have a Batman who rides around on a horse, works for Abe Lincoln, and hangs out with a Native American named Redbird, aka Robin. Mark Twain and Bill Hickok also make appearances, actually. So the story takes place during the Civil War, and Lincoln sends Colonel Wayne to go get a gold deposit in Nevada that will help with war efforts. And even though he's riding around during the daytime, he still wears his dark costume, which feels a little off-putting, cause I guess no camouflage and sun and whatnot. Talk about sticking out. Eventually his horse gets shot, and he whips out his cannons and literally says, "Those sons of whores killed my horse." That's basically how I feel every time my horse dies in Red Dead Redemption. So yeah, he kills everyone, it comes out that he's actually the leader of the bad guys, and Lincoln's like, "Oh boy, that's real awkward, man, I feel super weird about this now," and just doesn't work with him again. Is anyone else confused by the fact that his mustache disappears when he's wearing the bat suit though? Like seriously, major question. Consistency is key, guys. At number 2, we've got Bat Baby. Bat Baby was a product of a painfully funny arc that appeared in Batman 147 from 1961. First off, this cover is pure gold. Secondly, you can thank Superman for this gem. After success with a Super Baby storyline, Batman writers thought it would be a good idea to jump on that bandwagon. Fighting off against an evil scientist slash thug-esque character named Garth, yes, Garth, Batman is hit with a device that reverses the aging process. Then Robin takes him home in his arms when Batman can't move because his costume's too big. Then Bats realizes he's retained his adult strength and goes under some rigid training, for a day, to acquaint himself with his baby-sized body. Then goes off and fights crime, and Robin is like, "Oh, that's totally cool, this is totally fine and sane to do, to let a baby fight crime." And what does he do about that suit problem? He wears some overalls. Good solution, Bats. And at our number 1 spot, The Dark Knight Returns Batman. Before you all protest, The Dark Knight Returns is technically part of the Elseworlds imprint. DC has stated that it's part of a pre-Flashpoint DC universe and occurs on Earth 31. So here we have a man flirting with a traumatic past, an aged superhero questioning his notions of masculinity, surrounded by a new world of man-made technology and villains that come with it. The panel of a naked Bruce Wayne standing in the darkness of the Batcave, with Robin's costume the only shining light from within, is, well, I mean, I'll let you guys do the psychoanalysis on that one, friends. He comes out of retirement, no longer denying that his true identity is wearing the cape and cowl. Frank Miller's aged Batman has been credited for revamping the character in the 80s, reinvigorating the franchise and giving DC its edge back, a dark edge that had previously been diluted due to the Comics Code Authority and Frederick Wortham. It also retells Batman's origin story over a beautifully stark 86 panels, and contains two very important plot lines that Batman adaptations have been stealing ever since. Looking at you, Zack Snyder. Shouldn't have done that. There you guys have it. Who's your favorite version of the Caped Crusader? Let us know in those comments below. And if you have any suggestions for who should be next on the list, give us a shout. And make sure you hit that like button, subscribe, and share this video with a friend if you dug it. And be sure to check out all of our other alternate version series on our channel to get your superhero fill. But for now, I'm Kelly Pally for Top 10 Nerd, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.